So here in our Scree plot, notice first of all that on the x-axis, the component number is plotted. So this is the first component, second component, third, and so on. And on the y-axis, we have our eigenvalue plotted. And in fact, if you think about it, this graph is really just plotting. Notice this first value, 3.136. That is right here. Component 2 is somewhere between 0.6 and 0.7. And if you look here, here we go, component 2, 0.635. Notice component 3 drops off just a little. It is 0.534. Component 4 is 0.463. And then component 5 is 0.231. So this Scree plot is literally just these eigenvalues plotted from left to right. Now, the rule of thumb for interpreting the Scree plot is as follows. What we want to do is retain the number of components that are above what's known as the Scree, or where this plot tends to not drop much, when it tends to, I wouldn't say flatline, but taper off very gradually. Notice how these four points here, or these four eigenvalues, the rate of change or the slope here is quite minimal as we move across. But this value, there's a big drop from component 1 to component 2, and then from component 2 all the way through 5, there's not much of a change anymore. So according to the Scree plot, we interpret the number of components above where they tend to not change much anymore. And where this name comes from, the Scree plot, Scree is a geological term which indicates the rubble or the stones that fall from a cliff. So if you think of a cliff, you're driving along a road, you're going to see a lot of stones, smaller sized rocks, then some bigger rocks, but they're all collecting along the side of the mountain, right? Well, this is the scree or the rubble that is collected off the cliff. So that's where this name comes from. So we want to retain the number of components above the scree. So the Scree plot would indicate to us here that we want to retain one component. Suppose there was a component right here as well. We'll notice that it still drops quite a bit from here to here, and then it flatlines. So if we had a component here as well, then we would retain two components in that case. But since we only have one before the drop-off, then we're just going to retain the one component.